Council members, staff, and fellow citizens, I am honored to be your mayor and consider it a privilege to deliver the State of the Town address. What a great year 2013 was for Garner. A national real estate broker ranked Garner one of the 5 best cities or towns in North Carolina. Our citizens passed a $35.7 million bond referendum that will help move our town forward, and the National Civic League designated Garner an All-America City. The opening of the WakeMed HealthPlex with round-the-clock emergency care, the dedication of the Garner Veterans Memorial, and our first Garner 101 graduating class, all of these achievements have changed our town, and that change is good. Of course, real change does not occur overnight. It is the result of vision and planning and hard work, and we are reaping the benefits of all those things now in Garner. We're seeing things change, and that change is good. In 2013, Garner set the table for many positive changes in the coming years. In November, just ahead of a nearly $10 million bond issue, the town received a credit rating upgrade from Standard & Poor's that will save taxpayers money. That ratings boost is change, and that change is good. But it did not suddenly happen. It was the result of many years of prudent fiscal decisions by town leaders. For the longest time, we heard only talk about revitalizing and redeveloping our historic downtown and areas along the Highway 70 corridor. But thanks to the overwhelming support of Garner voters in last March's bond election, we're now on a course that will bring a new indoor recreation center to Main Street and open up a gateway off of Highway 70. That change will be good, and it will create opportunities for the private sector to get involved to a greater extent in downtown revitalization and redevelopment. That change too will be good. New businesses and investment continue to come to Garner in 2013. With Data Chambers and UltraPeer locating here and adding millions of dollars to the town's tax base. That change is certainly good for Garner. Late in 2013, the Garner Economic Development Corporation began aggressively marketing the former ConAgra site, now renamed the Garner Technology Center. The plans for the redevelopment of that site were not drafted overnight. They were well thought out over the course of several years, and now we are poised to see change on the site, and that change will be good. In 2013, we increased our visibility as a destination with the Cabela's announcement. Another contribution was our Broadway Voices series. The audience for our most recent Broadway Voices show last month included one state cabinet member, Elaine Marshall, members of the town councils in Cary and Marshall, and a school board member. People from all over the region are finding a reason to come to Garner, and that change is good. The improvements now getting underway on Highway 70 and White Oak will change the way motorists travel. The investment made by council in those improvements will return multiple benefits in tax base and quality of life to the town, and that change will also be good. Garner is not only a community that remembers the past and the sacrifices of those who have come before us. We're also a forward-looking community, especially where the arts and quality of life amenities are concerned. The programming at the Garner Performing Arts Center continues to be enhanced by the dedicated staff at GPAC and the Parks, Recreation, and Cultural Resources Department, and by partners such as the Garner Chamber of Commerce, the Town Players of Garner, and the Garner Revitalization Association, and other arts supporters in the community. The transformation we've seen at GPAC is more change that is good. Thank you to GPAC Manager Debbie Dunn for your vision and leadership. Debbie is just one example of the skillful and diligent staff we have working for the Town of Garner. Our Parks, Recreation, and Cultural Resources Department continue to receive recognition for its arts program, special events, trails, and more. This past year, the department received 2 statewide awards for its popular and innovative trick-or-treat, the Trails, the event held in White Deer Park. Our excellent town staff produced many other examples this year of award-winning efforts, from the work of the police department's canine units and crisis intervention officers to the work of our finance department for the budget document and various products shepherded along by our public information officer. Our staff's work has real-world impacts. Just a few years ago, we had no neighborhood improvement program, but with the appointment of Reginald Bowie as neighborhood improvement manager, citizen neighborhood watch groups and HOAs have been organized and work to address concerns in an effort to make all neighborhoods safe, pleasant, and inviting. That change is good too. In 2013, the municipal election returned 2 proven public service offices, and as they return, I tip my hat to the entire council. I salute them for the fiscal responsibility they have demonstrated over the years. As they continue to demonstrate good governance and an ability to work together for the good of Garner, this town will change, and that change will be good. And while I'm on the topic of the council, I want to take a moment to acknowledge all the ways that you contribute to the community. Kathy Behringer, who is involved in the Women's Club, serves on the Garner Revitalization Association Board, is town liaison to the Fire Department Board and Garner Education Foundation, and is also active in her church. Jackie Johns, who serves as a church deacon and is on the church's Board of Trustees, is a member of the Garner Concerned Citizens United and the Garner Economic Development Corporation Advisory Board. Buck Kennedy, who serves in Rotary, is a church deacon and is on the Garner YMCA Advisory Board. Ken Marshman, who volunteers with Meals on Wheels, serves on Rotary, the Board of Directors of the Garner Economic Development Corporation, and is a church deacon. And Grace Singleton, who volunteers with Meals on Wheels, coaches youth basketball, and is active in his church. In addition to the time that all of you give in your duties as an elected official, you always find time to give back to the civic, fraternal, and religious organization in our town. Thank you for that. The town government also benefits greatly from the assistance of citizens who volunteer for our advisory groups, and the volunteer spirit is alive and stronger than ever in Garner. Whether it's volunteering for Meals on Wheels at the Senior Center or working to make Garner's Relay for Life event the extraordinary success that it always is, or whether it's organizing Garner's MLK celebration now in its fourth year, Garner citizens are more engaged than ever. That's why we are an all-America city. That designation was not just a much-deserved validation of what this great town has achieved in the past. It is an endorsement of the path that we're on and an affirmation of what we are capable of doing in the future. Yes, great things do grow in Garner. This community continues to evolve and develop and blossom in new ways. It is the result of investments of time, money, and passion over many years. Our community remains close-knit, but it is indeed changing, and that change is good. Thank you. May God continue to bless you, and may God continue to bless Garner.